Good morning, children. Today we'll move on to the next part of the topic relation, where we'll be learning different types of relation. Okay, the first relation is one-one relation. Then we have one-to-many. Then we have many-to-one. And then we have many-to-many. So if I talk about one-one relation, it will be like this. Every element is associated with every unique element, like this. Now see, ये सारे elements को duplicacy नहीं है. Every element is associated with one unique element. Such relation is called as one-one relation. Like if I talk in mathematics, equal relation. Every number is equal to itself. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. Correct? So it is called as one-one relation. And one-to-many means like I am teaching to many students. Correct? I am teaching to many students. So it is one-to-many relation. It will be called as one-to-many relation. Then many-to-one. Many of you are learning from me. Many of you are learning from me. So many to one relation. And last one is many to many. Many people have opted for mathematics. Many have opted for physics. Many have opted for chemistry. So it is many to many. Many children have applied for many courses. So many to many. Okay. These finding this relation is very, very easy. Let us focus on more types of relation. In that, first one is reflexive. Then we have symmetric. And then we have transitive. There are three types of relation: reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. If in the set of relation you see A comma A, B comma B, C comma C, that is, both the components of the relation or the ordered pair are same, both the components are same, then that relation is said to be reflexive. If both the components are same, relation is said to be reflexive. The very well known example in mathematics is equal to relation. Every number is equal to itself. If I talk about natural numbers, at least every natural number is equal to itself. Correct? Such a relation is called as reflexive relation. This concept is true for every natural number. Har natural number ke liye possible hai, every real number ke liye possible hai. So it is reflexive relation. Okay? Then we have symmetric. If there is a relation or ordered pair A comma B, and at the same time also there is B comma A. If there is A comma A and also you can see B comma A, ऐसा है तो ऐसा भी दिख रहा है, then that relation is called as symmetric relation. Then we call it as symmetric relation. For an example, if line L1, if I say that line L1 is perpendicular to L2, by default I can say that L2 is also perpendicular to L1. अगर L1 L2 से perpendicular है, it means L2 भी L1 से perpendicular है. Correct? Also I can say congruency relation. B symmetric है. If A is equal to B, then B is also equal to A. Correct? Yes? Then आता है transitive. If there is an ordered pair A comma B and B comma C, these two elements must be same. अगर ऐसा pair है and this indicates that I also have A comma C, cut किया, I also have A comma C. If there is an ordered pair A comma B and B comma C, and if you find that there is an ordered pair A comma C also, then that relation is called as transitive. Like I'll give example, in mathematics, less than type relation. That is, 1 is less than 2, correct? 2 is less than 3. It by default implies that 1 is also less than 3. 2 cut kiya. So 1, 3 bhi hai. Agar A comma B hai, B comma C hai, and if A comma C is also there in that relation set, then that relation is called as transitive. And that relation is called as transitive relation. So a relation which is reflexive as well as symmetric as well as transitive. Ek aisa relation which follows all these three things is called as equivalence relation. What we call it as? Equivalence relation. A relation which is transitive, symmetric as well as reflexive, that relation is called as equivalence relation. The concept about this to be more clear when I deal with sums. Okay. The first one, I need to check the type of relation. Okay. A or B ordered pair will be formed only when A minus B is an integer. Also, the choice of A and B is also integer. So let us first talk about reflexive. Reflexive ka matlab kya hai? Both numbers are same. So if I do A minus A, A integer hai, ye A bhi integer hai. So if I do A minus A, what will I get? 0. A minus A kiya, kya milega? 0. And 0 is an integer. Correct? So this is A minus B is true for every equal number. A minus A, B minus B, C minus C, D minus D. That is 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, 3 minus 3. Koi bhi do same numbers, same integers ko subtract kiya, I will get the answer as integer. Yes. Therefore, I will say that this relation is reflexive. Kya bolenge? This relation is reflexive. Now symmetric. Symmetrically kya karte hain? If A comma B belongs to Z, if A comma B belongs to Z, and I'm assuming that A minus B also belongs to Z. You know that agar A comma B, A or B dono integer hai, inka subtraction bhi integer aayega. Do you agree? Yes. Similarly, if I say B comma A belongs to Z, by default I can say that B minus A भी integer आएगा. अगर A minus B integer है, तो B minus A भी क्या आएगा? Integer. मतलब relation में ये भी आएगा और relation में ये भी आएगा. If A comma B is there, B comma A भी आएगा because it should be an integer. Therefore, I say that relation is symmetric also. क्या बोलेंगे? Relation symmetric भी है. Understood? Now next is, if A comma B belongs to Z, then we know that A minus B integer है. Then अगर B comma C भी belongs to Z है, दो integers है, तो B minus C भी integer आएगा. At the same time, if I talk about A comma C, अगर A minus B integer है, B minus C integer है, तो A minus C भी क्या आएगा? Integer. अगर ये रिलेशन में है, ये रिलेशन में है, तो it will be by default present. Am I right? So relation क्या हो गया? Transitive भी हो गया. क्या हो गया? Transitive. अले example for this. 1 comma 3 relation में आएगा कि 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Minus 2 is an integer. 3 comma 5 फिर से integer आएगा. Also by default 1,5 भी क्या आएगा? Integer. Therefore, this relation is reflexive, symmetric as well as transitive. इसका मतलब क्या है? ये relation equivalence भी है. क्या है relation? Equivalence. Okay? Now next sum. Second one. If you don't understand, children, please do ask. It is little bit difficult to explain in a video. So I'll try my best. Let us say about this. A और B natural numbers है. दो natural numbers का addition even आना चाहिए. दो natural numbers का addition क्या आना चाहिए? Even. So if I take same numbers, I'll always get even number. 1,1 लिया, 1+1 कितना आएगा? 2. 3,3 लिया, 6. 2,2 लिया, 4. So if I take both A and B same, that is for A, belongs to natural number, A+A, क्या आएगा? Even number. By default, A+A क्या होगा? Even number. So I can say, this relation is reflexive. क्या बोलेंगे? This relation is reflexive. Then, if A,B, कोई भी दो random natural numbers लिया, and if I say that A+B is even, I'll take only those numbers जिनके addition even आता है. तो automatically उल्टा किया, B,A belongs to N, तो B+A भी even आएगा, है ना? अगर A+B even है, तो B+A भी even आएगा, correct? So ये क्या हो गया? Symmetric relation. क्या हो गया? Symmetric relation. Now third part, A,B belongs to N है, तो A+B even है, बराबर. Then B,C belongs to N है, suppose B+C even है, then what about A,C belongs to N? Will A+C always be even? हमें check करना है. So 1,3 लिया, even आएगा. 3,5 लिया, even आएगा. So 1+5, even आएगा. Do you agree? लेके देखते हैं. दोनों odd, या दोनों even लेके देखते हैं. 2,4 even है. 4,6 भी even है. तो 2,6 भी even आएगा. Now let's check two odd numbers. 1,3, 3, 5. 1,3 even है. 3,5 even है. तो 1,5 भी even आएगा. Am I right? Since it is talking about natural numbers, तो A+C भी क्या आएगा by default? Even आएगा. क्या आएगा A+C? Even. Am I right? Can I take any other example जहां पर even नहीं आएगा? No. Always it will be even. तो ये क्या आएगा? Transitive. मतलब ये reflexive भी है, symmetric भी है, और transitive भी है. Therefore it is equivalence. Now third one children, it is R, A,B, again they are talking only about natural numbers, A divides B, मतलब A divides B का मतलब क्या है? B divided by A, correct? So if I say that दो नंबर सेम है, A will always divide A. Do you agree? जब भी reflexive आता है, talk about same numbers. So every number is divided by itself. So A,A belongs to R. So relation is reflexive because every number is divided by itself. Correct? Then अगर A,B belongs to natural number है, and assume that B is divided by A. मैं assume कर रहा हूं कि B A से divide होगा. मतलब ये 2 है, ये 4 है. तो 4 will be divided by 2. Yes. But is it mandatory? अगर A divides B है, तो यहां पर ऐसा हो सकता है? No. Because अगर A 2 है और B 4 है, so 4 divided by 2 is okay. But उल्टा किया, will 2 be divided by 4? नहीं, तो रिलेशन सिमेट्रिक नहीं है. क्या नहीं है? इट इज नॉट सिमेट्रिक. दिस रिलेशन इज नॉट सिमेट्रिक. ठीक है. नाउ थर्ड पार्ट हमें देखना है ट्रांजिटिव के लिए. दैट इज इफ A,B रिलेशन में है, that is B can divide A. Then if I say B comma C belongs to R, it means C divides B. यहां B A के डिबल में आएगा और C B के डिबल में आएगा. So can you say about A comma C belongs to R रहेगा. Can I say C is divided by A? Can I say that? Think over it. हम लेते हैं एग्जाम्पल 2, 4. 4 can be divided by 2. Correct. ये लेते हैं 4, 8. So can I say 8 divided by 4? Yes. So last में क्या आएगा 2, 8. So can I say 8 divided by 2? Yes. है ना? By default LCM आएगा. So yes. So this is a transitive relation. क्या आएगा ये? It is a transitive relation. Okay? Next one, children. Okay. Now I already get. First, I need to split this to get the exact values of A and B because there will not be infinite values. So factorize करेंगे A square minus 4AB plus 3B square equal to 0. Multiply किया 3, add किया 4. क्या आएगा? Minus 3AB. Correct? A common A minus 3B, B common A minus 3B, either A minus B 0 आएगा और A minus 3B 0 आएगा. So either A is equal to B or A should be a table of 3. Correct? So A equal to B आया, मतलब I will get A comma A, B comma B, दोनों नंबर सेम होंगे. So this relation is reflexive. Correct? What about symmetric? अगर A B 1 है, B अगर 1 है, तो A 3 आएगा. B अगर 1 है, तो A कितना आएगा? 3. That doesn't mean 1 comma 3 possible है. This is not possible. क्योंकि A 3 times B है. This A is not 3 times B. So it is not symmetric. It is not symmetric. ठीक है? Then 3, 1 है. Transitive भी नहीं आया क्यों? अगला pair बनेगा ही नहीं. If you see, you will not get the next pair for transitivity. 3, 1 है. Let us check first. We can't directly declare. For transitivity, A bada hai and B should be small. So if I take B as 2, A will become 6. Hai na? B 2 liya, to A becomes 6. A will never be 2. Correct? So we'll never get this element as same. Are you getting it? So let us take with an example. If I say that A B set mein hai, it implies that A should be equal to 3B. And if I assume B comma C B set mein hai, it implies B should be equal to 3C by this property. So if I talk about A comma C, then there is a question mark whether I will get A equal to 3C. This we need to check. अगर A equal to 3C आ गया, then only I can say that it is transitive. तो A कितना दिया है? 3B. What is B? 3C. So what are getting A as 9C. A कितना आ रहा है? 9C. But what was my required answer? 3C, which is not possible. So it is not transitive. Understood? So it will not be a transitive relation. Clear? The remaining three sums I will leave on you. You will try. If any doubts, you will ask me. Okay, while solving these sums, take particular numbers, you will understand more better. Okay, so this was all about relations. We will go into more detail when we learn the next chapter, that is functions. Functions we will be doing later on. It is a little bit difficult. Okay, thank you.